Record right away, but I'll go ahead and talk first as the host. I'm going to let everybody know.
Real life.
I think we're live. Hey, everybody. I don't have a window open as an attendee because the sound would be ridiculous right now. I can't mute it and I would hear myself talk. So this is Marina and I's first webinar on Webinar Jam, which is really awesome software, and I hope I got my fingers crossed. I see you in the chat box, so I'm hoping that you can all see me. Actually, can somebody type to me? Can you hear and see both Marina and I?
Hello, everyone. Hi, good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming. Big webinar today. Thank you so much for all of your donations that happened to support our new program. So now you're going to see the difference, how everything is just going to be recorded at once.
Yeah, one video from now on.
And one video, you're gonna go directly to the link, and it's so easy to maneuver. I'm gonna play today all the messages that came, some of the messages, because we can't finish all of them. Some of the messages for telepathic connections. We're gonna talk about holographic extraction out of the quantum field, and it's all through the videos that we posted through Matt McElroy. So thank you so much, Matt, for helping us with that. And we also going to put all the webinars with our messages in YouTube. So we'll become international. So everybody from around the world can watch us live, becomes really a enlightenment community and help each other out with everything. Today the messages will be again holographic extraction from the hologram and how you connect with the ETs and how telepathically all the messages one after the other I'm going to play out from the video, and you're going to see at the same time the words. And at the moment we stop one video, after we stop the video, you're welcome to have your questions so we can discuss it. And next weekend, if we don't finish, depends how we finish, we're going to continue with everything. We're going to learn little by little. Have your questions ready. I'm probably going to play a couple of videos, discuss about it. So at least we have half an hour of discussion. Any questions? And I think that it's very fundamental for you guys to ask the questions.
Well, Marina,
Somebody, yeah.
I've got just a couple things to say real quick. We've got you guys, just everybody's probably getting used to this new software. It's pretty popular. A few of you might have used it before, but I just want to let you know, for some reason that I don't know yet, I'm still getting educated about it. There's a 10 to 15 second delay that I noticed, at least when we were testing. I don't know if it happens now live. But when Marina and I talk to each other, we hear each other instantly. But when we're talking to you guys might not be hearing us for 10 to 15 seconds later. So let's just see today if that's true, if it affects us at all. Maybe it'll be just fine. The other thing is, if you guys will look in your chat box there, you're going to see where there is at the top, I believe it's at the top, there's a choice that if you want to ask me, the owner of the channel, I'm the person operating everything. If you want to ask us to join in with Marina, I so me and Marina can see and hear you, and everyone else can see and hear you can do that. It's I think the button says invite as speaker, and we have one invitation right now. Carmen, I'm gonna set you up in just a minute as soon as I'm done.
Oh, Sia said no delay. She doesn't hear delay.
Well, they wouldn't be able to, I don't think they would be able to tell. Okay, Carmen, I just went ahead and let you, you're going to notice a change on your screen, and you're going to have to accept an applet on your internet browser. You won't have to really necessarily download anything, but you'll be downloading something, accepting it in your browser, not onto your laptop.
Hello
So
from
it should be fine.
Africa, whoever was from Africa, thank you for attending. I think I can see who was the person.
Africa, how did you, where do you see
Yeah,
them?
well, just said from some, yeah.
There is a delay?
Namibia, Africa. Carrie
Okay.
Ivo. Hello, Carrie. Hello, Namibia.
Oh, you see us on YouTube? Okay, so Marina, we do have a 10 to 15 second delay, but it doesn't look like is it interfering? No, yeah. Doesn't look like there's a problem with that. There's probably a good reason for that. Just like live radio and TV has a 10 to 15
second
delay.
Oh, maybe because something, yeah. We have to ask the staff for that.
And also YouTube, I was just informed that we look really good live on YouTube. So those of you that don't know, we're live on YouTube also, but you will not see the chat box on YouTube.
Yes.
You do?
There's a separate chat box.
Oh, well, there's a separate chat box on live YouTube. If you watch the video over, I was told you will not see it on recording on YouTube. So we're going to send you guys 4 hours from this, the time this webinar started. I've got it set at 4 hours. You're going to receive an email and it's going to give you a special link just for you to go watch this webinar free on webinarjam.com, our website, and you'll be able to watch the webinar exactly how it happened. You're going to be able to see the chat box and everything, but also if somebody happens to go to YouTube, you'll be able to see the webinar there. You just won't see the chat box in the recording. You can see it in the live show right now at my webinar link on YouTube. But for the webinar link, when we send you the replay, it's going to be called the live replay link. You can send that to all your friends, okay? It doesn't matter. The link you have to get into this live presentation now is just yours. You can't send that to your friends. It won't work properly. Everybody needs their own unique link. But the replay link that we'll send you in 4 hours through email, you can copy and paste that and give it to all your friends. It doesn't matter. It's a free replay, okay? Marina, I'll go ahead and let you take it over.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for coming today. I'm so happy. It's our first webinar through this website, Webinar Jam. So thank you so much for all your help. You're going to see big difference now. Again, today we're going to play some of the messages. After I play one message, it's usually like 3 minutes or 3 to 4 minutes each. I'm going to stop and I'm going to discuss it. In the meantime, have your questions. If you have a question, so we may go to 2, 3, 4 messages today, and we're going to discuss after each one because it could be complex and I don't want anybody to get confused. So it's telepathic connection, hologram, how you connect with your family, and every webinar we're going to discuss new messages. We're going to go through it. We're going to see it. So we'll be able to help each other through the process. That's how it works. So today I have the hybrid group with us. I know they told me right before the webinar there's a spacecraft above the structure. I don't know where exactly, but they told me it's a spacecraft. And the 11 dimensional beings will, they said that it will come a little bit later. So I'm going to let you know what it is. Don't forget that I have open channeling. If you have a question, the information will come directly. If I close my eyes, I'm aware, but because I don't want to get distracted, especially if it's something with physics, you know, so I want to focus on directly the channeling. Okay, so now the first thing I want to go through is the hologram, how the hologram works. Then I'm going to discuss more about the hologram. Let's play the video that I have. I'm going to open up right now the screen. Everybody, do you see the screen? Do you see everything clear?
Yep.
Okay, do you see all the writings and stuff? Okay, I'm going to go ahead now and play the video, which is about the 11 dimensional beings when they were talking about the hologram and how we're going to get extracted from the hologram. Listen to exactly what they said. Then I'm going to channel more on that and have your questions ready with that. Okay, here it goes.
Are you playing the video, Marina?
Yes.
Well, I can't hear I barely hear it.
Okay.
I think it's because you have your earphones plugged in. We need to hear it through your speakers.
components and then reality. So
there we go. There we go.
To have a visit with you, we usually extract you from your hologram. That is, for example, vibration of 1.13005 hertz, and we implement you to the new of frequency that is 2.7383 hertz above the frequency of yours. So this way you have no idea what is happening out of your reality and you are not aware, because the third and fourth dimensional brain frequency hertz vibration is not registering the sequence. It is not capable of memorizing because your body vessel membranes are not vibrating and increased into our vibrational hologram frequency hertz. In reality, each hologram has its own hertz signature. So when you shift through your daily life moment to moment, it is usually very slight fractal difference, and that is why you don't see the difference. But in order for you to become multidimensional body vessels and pop up above the third dimensional holographic reality, which is more dense, you have to increase your body membrane's molecular vibration hertz, and then you can easily connect with full memory of the other, more or less intensity realities. Less intensity realities, which is usually above the third dimensional structure. This is why it is so fundamental to be so pure, not only in your heart, but also in your body, so you can extract yourself into multiple realities at the same time with full memory. That memory can feel physical experience for you. So really there is not much difference. It is illusion. All of it. The density is different and the hertz vibration is different too. But nevertheless your experience and your membranes can withhold the memory's hertz. So you see, you can all do that, but you must increase the vibrational hertz of each molecule of your dense body. And once your body is ready, we are willing to make our contact with you more permanent. You see, we are always here. But not all of you can withhold our frequency hertz, so this is one reason why you don't remember our visits, because we see you in less density reality hertz, which Marina, your brain memory does not vibrate. Nevertheless, your higher consciousness knows it and you can always extract it out of the quantum field, but it is not like what you call physical. In order to be physical, do increase your body and mind molecular vibration above the third dimension, and then we are with you all physically. So you see there is work to be done. We are showing you the way. And yes, we can lower our frequency hertz to yours and have a contact in your physical reality, but it is usually very brief. So to increase the frequency of yourself, be at all time loving, giving to humanity with no explanations. We see all of you. We know what you do in your daily life and how you behave. Again, your popularity, money, and fame will not be the criteria for us. But how much you do for humanity out of your pure hearts. So be giving, be love, be the light. Because consciousness has no limits. Everything is possible. Everything. We love you all. End of transmission.
Did everybody understand this? Okay, what... if there's any questions, you can start with the questions. I'm going to start explaining the whole structure now, what they were saying here. The goal for all of us is to absolutely increase the frequency vibration of your consciousness and your body at the same time as one unit. The reason for that they're saying is so you can have a, in order for you to have a physical contact and telepathic contact first. First, you have to have a telepathic contact. You have to construct that in your consciousness. And this is the reason why the next messages that we're going to listen were how to increase the probabilities for telepathic contact. What that means is you have to raise your frequency of your consciousness and your body at the same time to certain vibrational sequence, so they will be able to implement their structures and vibrational sequences in their in your consciousness, because everything is simultaneously running. They are existing in their reality, but at the same time you're creating a new reality between them and you, so you can put them in your consciousness. But in order to do that, the vibrational sound and the vibrational signal has to somehow match theirs. And this is the preparation. That's what they talk about holographic expression, because as you know, if you've been listening, everything that I've been talking about in the harmonic reactor, Marina Jacobi, the harmonic reactor video, the one that I'm in front of a whiteboard, that is one of the most important videos you should watch before you get in into my material, because then I'm explaining all the structure. So the parallel realities are running simultaneously at the same time. You're co-creating a brand new now when you start raising the frequency of your body and your consciousness. So since every single reality is a holographic expression out of your consciousness, they exist already in that reality. Okay? So they want us to understand that once you do that, understand that they're already existing in a holographic reality that is vibrating in a certain vibrational sequence. And once you end up putting that probability in your consciousness and you start vibrating in that sequence, you have you're starting to have telepathic connection. And why, the reason why you need a telepathic connection first is because you need to crystallize it in order to become physical, moment to moment to moment, in order to be 100% visible for you. So this is the preparation. What you see right now, it's a preparation. But at the same time, doesn't mean they may have a massive, you may say massive, but don't forget what I was saying. What they were saying, that each one of us already made it in a structure, that each one of us right now is creating a hologram of ascension process of the planet Earth. At the same time, we have collective experience the way we're having it right now. So that means that I may have a contact tomorrow physical, because me individually being every single day constantly talking about it, constantly doing, you know, the stuff that I need to raise my frequency. And we discuss how you do that. We can discuss that if you have questions more about that. And eventually, when you by agreement reach the momentum, you know, and the frequency, the proper frequency, you may have the physical contact. How is going to be this physical contact? They're never gonna tell you. Because it's also probabilities, maybe something need to be twitched, maybe some vibration they're helping with. We're always being helped, you know, how the body is going. So that was the whole idea about the structure of the hologram. They can basically extract you also out of the hologram. You don't remember that though, because your vibration is not vibrating in that sequence. If your vibration is vibrating that sequence, you're going to have a physical contact. Okay, but you may have a memory of it. If you have a memory of a physical contact, in order for you to even have the memory, that means existing a structure. But you want to make it physical. And in order to make it physical, you have to stay and you have to implement and you have to start raising your frequency of the body and the mind at the same time. One unit. Any questions about that? Because I'm going to move to telepathic connection day one video. But I want you to, if you have any questions, please ask me so I can channel or whatever that is. Any questions about that? And no, I don't speak Spanish. I'm sorry. Somebody was asking if I speak Spanish. No questions about that video? Okay.
By the way, in the chat box, you can put to make it easier for me and Marina Nida's questions, you can change the bottom left. If you click on the drop down arrow, it says answer. Yours is question. There you go. Great question, Mark. So we know that you're actually asking a question you want answered. It'll help us a lot because I'd like to announce we've had a record attendance of 83 people in our room for our webinar. This is the first time ever that we have gone over 25.
Thank you so much. Okay. You will not be able to broadcast on your phone. So you have to use computers for this broadcasting, okay?
Well, somebody, yeah, they, yeah, they, They can clear Marina. They can hear us. They can see us on their phone. They just can't join with their video camera. We won't be able to share their video camera from their phone. Only a laptop.
Okay, somebody has that. That means somebody had a question here, but I cannot see who is the person. Does that mean
it's our experience
is Christine?
Yes.
She's asking,
yes.
Does that mean our experience actualization physical contact will be different from each other? Very good question. Thank you. Yes. That means, remember when I was discussing that each one of us is projecting a hologram from our consciousness, thoughts, and emotion, becomes a plasma and gravitational field. And this plasma and gravitational field is the one that projecting into the field around you and creates a holographic expressions of different of a hologram. And what you see in actuality is a picture frame of a hologram. The only reason you think is physical is because the way the matter and the energetic field works is more dense. But in actuality is complete illusion. You're literally a hologram, because if you put your hand under electronic microscope, you're going to see light. You don't see any vessels or bones. You see light. We're light. The only reason you see matter is because the way you gave agreement, your consciousness to vibrate to certain vibratory rate in order to project so-called physical. But so-called physical is literally illusion. Remember, you are the projector, you are the maker. Whatever you think is getting into the quantum field and is coming back to you, and you're projecting. So your thoughts, your emotion, and your deeds is the one that creates your reality. So if you see something in front of you, you create it and nobody else put it there. So we're going to talk about manifestation. One of these webinars is fundamental, because manifestation is all connected with all that. Then you're going to know how to manipulate a structure and why things are happening into you. Okay. And so, yes, you are seeing, because you are creating your own hologram of ascension. That means your experience could be completely different than my experience. Your experience will be accordingly to your vibration that you've been giving up from your thoughts, emotions, and deeds. So, for example, if you every day in a daily basis, you behave nicely towards people, you watch nice movies, or you are generous, or you are doing everything out of your heart without expectations, the way, for example, we do everything out of our hearts and doing a free webinars, instead charging you money, instead we asking for donations if you wish to donate or something, that's all up to you. It's a free energy exchange. Is not done by condition, is fundamental for the structure. When you do out of your heart everything without expectations, you do not put any condition in a quantum field of the structure. In turn, the quantum field will give you probabilities of manifestation to infinity. It doesn't have to be only to the monetary system, could be directly through donation, could be somebody give you exactly what you need. If you need a couch, somebody is gonna give you the couch. You don't have to pay the money, or you don't have to go work and get the money. Yet money is part of creation. You don't reject it. So if it comes to you, accept it gracefully, but it doesn't mean you have to give people in the name of the money. That's an illusion. That's what you were teaching me. $1 and $1 million is no difference. Your vibratory rate is the one that make determination of how you receive stuff. That's manifestation. And we're going to talk about this one day. The whole webinar is going to be about manifestation. So, yes, you experience your own reality. What I will experience, the ascension, could be completely different than yours. And that is because I'm creating my own hologram. I'm creating my own structure. I do the stuff different than you are. So my vibration, my agreement, it could be completely different experience. So that means it doesn't matter what is out there. Your state of being is what is really important. The state of being is actually the vibrations of your thoughts, emotions, and deeds at the same time. That's what determines what holographic expression you have, what parallel reality you're creating, and what ascension process you're doing. And that is for everybody. In the meantime, we have a collective. The way, for example, we have a collective, each one of us lives in a different location, but at the same time, collectively, we're creating this reality because there's no time. And no time is the most fundamental thing for you to know, because everything is running, every reality parallel is running simultaneously. Okay, so now I'm going to play video number two, day one, and that is integration of the extraterrestrial energies in your body, and that is through the telepathic connection. You're going to see in the screen also the writing. And let me know if you can hear clear enough and have your questions ready after that so we can discuss it, okay? So this is video number two. I'm going to be playing.
What makes an endless magic?
Just to skip the the survey.
Marie LeJacobi, integration of the AT energies in your bodies.
11 dimensional beings, January 19th, 2017. Day one. Dear family, we are the 11 dimensional beings. In the next 20 days from now, we will give you messages every day. First, we cannot stop the levels of frequencies that are integrating in your systems because they are coming from the central sun, and the higher order of consciousness is also involved. This momentum was predetermined from many millenniums ago. That is why to think that you can manipulate the outcome for the freedom of humanity is reader silly. You can no longer enslave humanity. It will not be allowed any longer to manipulate humanity, no matter how hard certain groups are trying to do so. So please stop now. We promise you that you will find yourself in a very difficult situation. To you humans, the new frequency hertz is infusing your potential to connect the variables of your systems in molecular structure with all the new relativities of the quantum fields. This was necessary because you cannot increase your frequencies yourselves. It was too much suppression and manipulation from certain dark entities in your planet. Now we know that you see so many changes, but we want to tell you that is all an illusion. You already know the outcome. Your freedom is in your heart being energy. It is in your freedom and your liberty of sovereignty. Collective modules are also implemented in your daily basis, but this is mostly done from your galactic families. Each one of you is constantly connected with your galactic families. Right now all the systems are being activated energetically, and that will also change your genetic predisposition. Once the energetic genome is activated and permanently established in your body systems, then you will start to have different experiences. This experience could be lucid dreams. A glimpse of knowing that the person that is talking to you has ET consciousness attached for a brief moment through permission with the individual you are looking at that moment. This is done so you slowly are able to withhold the energetic hertz imprint from the extraterrestrial galactic family in your conscious energetic systems. The systems must be activated one by one until they work in absolute unity synchronization. From now on, all of you will have memory experience of some extraterrestrial integration. Attention to all humans. We already did all the integration in your body. Ha ha ha. Surprise. You are already activated. Time is an illusion. Shift now to the momentum and know that you are integrated. This is our present from us to you all. Right now you just need to withhold the memory and recall that emotional frequency, then look at the image and hold it. And we promise you that your higher self knows all the system. All that you need to know at this moment will be in your memory bank. So enjoy your exploration. We see you all. Till next time. End of transmission.
Did you guys hear
me?
Yes.
When you're done playing the videos or any you want us to hear on your desktop, could you just put your headphones back on so you don't hear? They're hearing my echo, like when I talk, just like I am.
Can you hear me well now?
Yeah, perfect.
Okay, thank you. Okay, what was happening here? It was like exactly what I was talking just seconds ago. The whole thing here is they already implemented certain structure for us. So you will be able to actually put the contact in your consciousness already. They already, what they're doing right now is planting a seed. So you give the ability and the probability in your consciousness to accept that vibration, because they're already sending a signal of vibration. So you can, if you wish to accept it. Remember, this is all by wishing. If you were not ready, you wouldn't be here in this webinar. Okay, I just want to tell you that one. If you're not on the timeline of telepathic connection, galactic connection, you're not going to be in this webinar. Everything is happening for a reason. So you're here because you're in the timeline for intergalactic connection. Otherwise, would not be even in your consciousness. Okay, this way they infusing the realities the way they were saying. So we have the probability of absolute connection with them. And when they talk, you already made it. Remember when I was talking about there is the fact that we, since everything is running parallel, you already exist in with your intergalactic family. You're already there. But by agreement, you've seen only the holographic expression of your consciousness through this, Earth reality, because you gave an agreement. What they're trying to do right now is to connect you again with your higher self in your family by implementing the new frequencies in your consciousness. And the goal is to crystallize it, but you staying with it moment to moment to moment. And when you do that, eventually, by your own agreement, you're going to have a connection with your galactic family, or you're going to have a lucid dream. The connection will be different for everybody. Somebody may have physical, somebody can have an astral projection, somebody can have in a dream, somebody can have a lucid dreaming, somebody can literally have experienced the way we have right now. Because right now you also have connections with them. I may be the vessel right now. The goal is for us to start doing it ourselves. So you don't need me any longer. My goal is not for you to constantly come, but for you to start having a connection. And the reason why they said we're already here, ha ha ha, surprise, you're already activated, because you're already existing in the other reality. You're already between them. But the only reason you see this reality is because you're vibrating in a different vibratory structure. You have to increase it by staying with it and by start practicing on that. You already know what to do. This is just a wake-up call. Hello, we're here. Connect. That's how it works. Any questions about this? Remember, time is an illusion. And let me explain how time goes for the people that never listened to the video. When you give a, if I give you a mathematical equation of movement, when I move my hand from here to here, I'm going to give you the mathematical equation and the result of it. When I have the result of that equation, if I put another mathematical equation on top of this result from the speed of the planet, then we, on that result, I put the speed of the galactic, then the speed of the cluster and the whole universe. What is showing you is that you're not traveling, you're flickering through time space. Basically, you're shifting like a snapshot from one reality to another. And the way you're shifting is through the black hole portals that is in every single particle. This is the reason how we're traveling through time space. We're going to talk about technologies one day. With all the harmonic reactor, that's going to be another stuff, how everything is integrated now, technologies. But before you get to this point, I want everybody to learn first this, because it's fundamental how we do manifestation, how the structure works. Then we can move into technologies if you want to. Okay? So that's how this works. You're shifting moment to moment, but you already made it, and you're actually dreaming the ascension process right now. But isn't that dreams look like real? So the point is that once you match the frequencies, their connection with you, when you have that experience, would also be like real. Even if the vibration is different, it's a real for you. That's how it's going to look like. Okay. Oh, and they just wanted me to tell you that basically You also, right now, you may sit with them, but if you try to have a memory of connection with them, each one of you right now will have somewhere in their memory bank connection. I'm sorry. This is a phone call. I don't know how to stop that. Just a second, everybody.
You can just hit the red button, Marina.
Okay, I got it.
I guess that was Skype. That wasn't our.
That was Skype. I'm sorry, okay. Everybody. Sorry.
Okay, so where did you leave off on the questions? Do you want me to find some more questions here?
Yeah, get our questions, please. Thank you.
Okay. So let me go all the way down to the last one. I think you talked about already how to raise your frequency, your hertz, how to raise your vibration. Did you talk about that enough?
No, did anybody ask about that?
Yes, Todd wants to know what are some techniques that people can use to upgrade frequencies, their hertz, to more easily connect with the higher beings or their guides and things like that.
Okay, we're going to talk about that. And then there's a question from Steve that talks about the sun. I need to address that too. Okay, we're talking here about manifestation. Okay, to raise the frequency of your body, anything, the consciousness itself is a little bit more towards the positive, okay, not towards the negative. And the reason for that is because consciousness would not exist if you're constantly doing something negative, it will disintegrate, it will destroy itself. So no matter what somebody is doing, and no matter what is happening, eventually is going to end up being in a positive because consciousness has to preserve itself to exist. Okay, so that's why if somebody thinks that it's never going to happen, that we is doomsday, we're never going to get better, that's an illusion, because consciousness always going to go for the benefit of survival in the end. No matter what it is, by conditioning, by agreements, it always going to go for survival, to preserve itself. Okay, so that's why we're in the ascension process for the benefit of humanity. Put in your consciousness and think that it's for the benefit of humanity, no matter what you see. The goal for that is the way the 11 dimensional being, the hybrids. Ra is my higher self. You guys know that if you read my material from the harmonic reactor and listen to my videos. It's all about raising your emotions and deeds from your heart. A heart itself has a specific frequency and consciousness itself. That's why whatever you want to listen to, go from the heart, listen to your heart. It's an emotion, it's a specific frequency, not what you're thinking, because your thinking is the three-dimensional, is something that you end up taking depending on belief system that is being given to you. In actuality, your heart is your true self, true consciousness. So if you listen to your heart, not your head, because somebody else implemented some kind of a belief system that could be also manipulative through media or some other sources, it will steer you off the true self of consciousness, which is pure love, because it's preserving itself, it's for survival. Also, the way you do that is day by day, from your heart, start giving to people, start doing everything without expectation, without thinking that in order for me to help that person, I want to gain something. When you do that, you put in a condition in a quantum field that you are made of. That means you put in a certain vibration. And because you are creation, you are the structure, whatever that condition and vibration is, has a certain frequency, you're giving this in a quantum field. And the only way for you to have the abundance will be accordingly to the condition that you end up giving. So in order for you to see the abundance, you have to be the abundance. That is a quantum metaphysical law that was the first thing they taught me. And it was the hybrids, was the Galactic Federation. I had Ra, my higher self. I had the Council of Nine and the 11th dimensional being. Everybody came in to specifically ask me to do it this way. Why is that? Because consciousness itself is all by giving. And in order for me to see the ascension process and for me to create absolute abundance, I have to be the abundance myself. So I start helping. We start doing everything with Ron by literally broadcasting, helping. And look at this, it's growing more and more and more. And we are supported sometimes. People sometimes donate to support my family or donate to Ron or donate for a cause. It always works in both ways. We all helping each other. That's how it works, because consciousness itself, creation itself is to preserve itself. So if you listen to your heart is the true higher self of consciousness. So if you start giving to each other, and if you start moment to moment to moment, hold the positive frequency of giving without expectation, and hold your emotion in joy and love towards others, even if you see what's happening right now. Right now, I see a lot of political situations. For example, I'm giving an example, that people starting blaming each other. Who did what? Why is that person? Why is the other person? Everybody is trying to convince the other person that they are right. The truth is that every single person for itself is right for themselves. And why is that? Because it's a parallel reality. Every individual for themselves, depending on their belief system and vibrational sequence of their being, are projecting for themselves their own timeline of ascension process. And for them, through their consciousness, their belief system is true. In the meantime, from your consciousness, your belief system is true. What you need to do is to accept somebody else's belief system, because it's projected from their own belief system and consciousness. You cannot judge or overtake somebody else's belief system. If you do that, it's against the law of creation. And if you reject, or if you go after somebody, you're projecting that frequency into the quantum field. And in turn, you're going to have an experience that somebody is going to do that to you, because you're out of balance with creation of pure love itself. That's why. And in order, when you lower your frequency by, and how do you lower your frequency? By you being mean to somebody, by not being given, by constantly having expectations in order for you to give, or by simply being sad, very emotional, all that, it's showing you that you're off balance. Because your true self of higher self is showing you, wait a minute, you're off balance with creation that is pure love. Then it's giving you, except for you to say, oh my God, I can't believe this is happening to me. What consciousness is showing you that you're off balance with the pure structure of love. What you need to do is at that time is to pull out, say to yourself that you're a hologram. Give a gratitude to everything you have around, because gratitude is 0 point, and you're not giving any judgment towards whatever you see, because now you give pure abilities for every new frequency to come in for manifestation. And then when you do that, you say, I'm a hologram, I can project anything I want, and now lift your emotion with a positive thinking. Thank you for showing me, because what you're showing you is simply a holographic expression of where you are in the quantum field. Because if you don't know where you are, you're going to pop out the reality, and you're not going to know where you are in the realities. You need to know where you are. So that's what it's showing you, but you don't have to act on it. You just accept it, and now lift your emotion feelings by projecting complete love and understanding and gratitude towards that person or situation, and move on with a positive thinking. That's how you shift. That's how you project positive, and that's how you raise your frequency by moment to moment, acting from the best of your abilities from your heart. Because if you do that, not only you connecting with the higher self of consciousness, but then you do not have a friction in a structure. That's a quantum physics law. You don't have a friction in the structure, and everything is coming smoothly to you, except for you to keep projecting challenges that you want something, but you cannot achieve it because constantly something is stopping you. It's stopping you because you end up projecting it from your consciousness. You cannot see something in front of you if you didn't project it. So something is out of balance. Balance it by pulling it out, give a gratitude, and now feel gratitude, emotion of love and joy, and hold that frequency moment to moment to moment throughout your day, daily life. And tune in with the right people. Get into detox. You have all my videos of detox, Marina Jacobi detox. You're going to see everything how to detox. I did it in the name of all humanity. It's all for free. You can do follow step by step. It's going to help you to detox. I'm talking about elimination diet, detox diet, probiotics. Everything is there for you. If you want to tune into all that, all the knowledge is there for you to help.
And
you
I shared your website, Marina, marinajacobi.com. I've shared the link a few minutes ago.
Well, thank you so much. And now let's move on. There was another question about the sun. Did you see that question?
Yeah, what, Marina, I just noticed in my control panel, I have all the questions separated here. I didn't even know this. I just learned it. So it's really easy for me to get this for you. First, let me ask you, are you done sharing your desktop or do you have more to show us? Because I want to get some folks on their cameras.
Maybe we should start with the questions. Next time we continue with more of the messages. Let's start with the questions so you guys can, so it's not too much of the metaphysics. Next time we're gonna move on to number two video and talk more about it. Let's start with the questions.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So here's a good question by Anne. Anne is asking, why do people with that appear to have a low vibration often become millionaires?
Say it again. I'm sorry. I was off for a second.
Why do people that appear to have a low vibration become millionaires or multimillionaires even?
Well, first of all, very good question. Thank you. That doesn't mean that all the millionaires are actually with a low vibration. Again, money is part of the structure. Some of these people, believe it or not, is going to be the pioneers that are going to help humanity to build these factories for the free energy. So you have the white hats from all that. And sometimes in order to know what the negative side is doing, you have to be in between, in the center, to know exactly what's happening, because how are you going to be able to defeat a negative side from outside? It has to be from the inside. So don't think that everybody that is doing that is doing because of a negative aspect. Plus, before you came here to planet Earth, you gave an agreement to come and become a multimillionaire or to have a certain experience. But through that experience, once you become a millionaire, multimillionaire or a billionaire, you have the choice to use it towards positive or towards negative. You may have agreements to become very wealthy, but how you use that agreement is by choice. So that's why it's so tricky here, because a lot of people can do, for example, what I do with Ron, but they may use it through the monetary system that becomes very lucrative. And the only time they can help is the people that, for example, pay money. That's not the goal here. The goal is to help everybody, not only certain group.
So, Marina, let me ask some questions that might come up in their minds, because it's coming up in mine. So does that mean that it's really not true that if you vibrate low, you're going to be poor? You're not poor because you're vibrating low, right?
The low vibration is just an illusion, because at the same time, that vibration could be you need to learn some kind of a lesson. If you have a lesson to learn, you're going to have somebody steal everything away from you. That particular person that stole everything away from you was probably your biggest teacher, because he's teaching you, for example, to learn forgiveness. So you can raise your frequency through forgiveness. Okay? So you have to really pull out, in any situation that you have in, you have to look at it through the structure. If you look at it through the structure, you're going to understand that in order that person to do something there, he did it because you end up projecting it in your hologram by agreement. So if it's there, I have to learn something. What can I do to make the situation into positive? By pulling out, accepting the person that is doing something, by not going after the person, but give a gratitude for showing you that something is off balance, and you give a love and understanding, but you don't have to go after the person. You may move on, but give love, gratitude, and move on, but do not go after the person. If you go after the person, you're projecting the same thing in the structure. You're not better than that person. Okay, so be very careful how you implement the structures. That's why if you learn the structure, you're going to be able to manipulate and you're going to choose very clearly what to do next, what to project next. The only thing that you cannot change, if you have by agreement to meet, marry, to make a lot of money or something, once you do that agreement, how are you going to implement and what the outcome of that agreement is accordingly to your choice. And that will go to a probabilities of multiple realities.
Okay, so there's no real direct correlation between, we could be the best people in the world. We could be nice to everybody, no matter what they do to us. We could eat the best food in the world. We could do everything to vibrate high. And that does not mean that we're going to be rich, because it has no connection there, right? It's just about our choices and our agreement.
That's right. The question is coming from a monetary understanding, monetary system. In actuality, the way they taught me that's an illusion. It's simply money is just a part of a structure. But it's limiting you. Because you can manifest from your consciousness, you can project parallel reality, and you can shift yourself into parallel reality of existence, that whatever you need is simultaneously there for you, just literally pops up. But how you gonna get it, you don't know. You don't know whatever you need, you're gonna get it from a friend. You don't know if somebody donates money to you. You don't know if you're gonna find that on the street. You don't know, because consciousness can project that whatever you need through infinity of probabilities to you. So to think that it's only through the monetary system, whatever we need, guess what, is an illusion. Because I can give you another scenario and let me implant that seed for you of probabilities reality. You can literally have in a timeline extraterrestrials coming and literally in a day can construct a brand new city for you that you don't have to do all the steps by step of somebody giving you mini money, so you build a factory, so you start implementing the cars. That for me will be the ideal, because for me, I don't need to go through the process. But if I made an agreement that I gotta go through the process so I can help everybody else along the way we're doing right now, I have to go through it. But in actuality, there is a reality, if I think about it, that already exists, that they come in and build brand new city for us. And it's all done. Except going step by step of, you know, everything else.
Okay, so I think everybody out there just needs to understand that doing your best to be a good person, educate yourself, feel your intuition from the higher power, the higher guidance, and be enlightened, vibrate high. That just means you're going to live a better life. You're going to be the... which is why a better lifestyle, which is why I created the brand, Live the Enlightened Lifestyle, because you're going to be as happy as you can be if you're doing all these things right. And that doesn't mean you're going to be a millionaire. It's just, you know, you're going to have everything you need. And if that means being a millionaire, then maybe you're even luckier. That's the icing on top of the cake. So you want to go to the next questions here, Marina?
Yes.
We've got a lot. So,
Erica, I see Erica.
Well, I'm looking at just the questions. And let me remind everybody that please put a big red question mark on your questions when you ask a question. Your chat box is going to allow you to change it from just chat, like chatter, just talking and agreeing with me, Marina and I. It's going to allow you to write on your left of your chat box. It's going to allow you to click the drop-down menu and choose the big red question mark, and then type your question. Okay, that way we can, it'll make it easier for me to be able to tell the difference between chatter and questions. So the next question here is from Christine. It says, so how does co-creation from two souls occur?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Christina asks, how does co-creation from two souls occur?
Oh, by agreement. It's coming from agreement. Before you were born, you existed in your true self, could be from the Pleiadians or could be in a high dimension, because remember, I was saying that's fundamental knowledge. Above the extraterrestrial, there's a higher consciousness that they can change bylaws and stuff depending of how you basically connecting through what timeline you connected, the way I connected through the Pleiadian structure, but I'm also connected with my higher selves and the 11 dimensional beings and Council of Nine. That is a different levels. Okay. It's not only the extraterrestrials. Okay. So by agreement, you gave that, okay, I'm going to be born in America. This is going to be my parents because I need to learn compassion, commitment. My parent is going to be, for example, divorcing it when I'm 10 years old. And if you have the bylaws, they're going to happen no matter what you do. Once they happen, depending on how you accept that and how you're doing and how you understanding everything and how you accepting the lessons, that timeline is shifting to probability of reality is what's going to happen to you. But then 3 years later after that, you may have another agreement that no matter what you do is going to happen. For example, your mother's going to remarry it again. And now you're going to have a sibling brother that is going to be very good to you. And you guys can open business when you get older. So this is the stuff. But in the meantime, it's all by probabilities. You can choose after that how this can play out. Does that make sense? So it's all by agreement. Everything is happening. It's all by agreement that you came in a timeline for ascension. You wouldn't be here in this webinar if not a timeline for that. So it's all by agreement. You agreed to come to this webinar. It's all by agreement. But now how well you understand this webinar, and if you choose to stay or leave the webinar, this is a probability now for you. You can choose to do that. But you already had a by agreement to come in this webinar, otherwise you wouldn't be here. How well you implement that, it's all up to you. And now this splits up on realities. Because the reality for you to stay in a webinar is simultaneously running with the reality that you don't stay in a webinar. Which one you choose, you take an action towards it. And that's how you infuse it to become physical.
Okay, let's move on to the next question. Sia, I hope I'm saying her name right. She says, I wake in the morning and I feel like I have been somewhere and doing a lot of something, but don't remember any details, only faint visuals. How do I cause myself to remember? So maybe she's having lucid dreams or something like that.
Their suggestion is to, if you have that type of feeling, your consciousness already is trying to recall something. It's waking you up because the new frequencies that came in, they're starting to, they actually activated your consciousness, your DNA code. And that's the reason why you started saying, oh, something is happening. I cannot quite understand why. Now your time is to get involved with that because it's basically waking you up. And the way you involve yourself is exactly the way you're doing right now, by reading material right now and learning all the stuff. And then their suggestion is, in a situation like this, if you want to have more physical understanding, go and learn lucid dreaming. Try, buy a book. I always recommend this guy. His name is Nick Barrett. You know, he's on YouTube, Nick Barrett Lucid Dreaming. You can get his book or listen to his video. I got his book when I wanted to do that. It took me practicing literally 2 weeks until I became lucid in my dream. And when I became lucid in my dream, every single time I open up a portal with my thoughts and I wanted to go get in a spacecraft Every single time I was stopped, they told me that I cannot get in, because even with all the stuff that I do, I was not allowed to be there yet, because my job is to get a physical contact. That's my agreement. So I got to do all the juicing, all the stuff, all the food that I got to do. So I raise my frequency of my body to vibrate in a certain vibration so I can withhold for a long period of time their vibration physically, except for them helping me all the time. That is my agreement. Some people can have a glimpse of it usually, but they be helping, somebody's holding their vibration. Okay, so that's how it works. Go into lucid dreaming and experience that. Within the lucid dreaming, you're gonna start seeing stuff, and you can control it, where to go, what to do. For me, it was not necessary to continue, because already lucid dreaming, it's another reality like this one. It's literally the same. The only reason you think that this reality is completely different than dreaming is because we were implemented and thought about it in our consciousness, but that's an illusion. When you dream, is another reality like this one. Absolutely like a this one. But
so like another dimension or a another reality? Is it two? Is
vibratory reality, yes, different dimensional thing? Reality, parallel dimensional reality. That's what it is. So when you wake up, you can control it, but doesn't mean that your guidance or ET family will allow you to get to certain locations, because you may not be ready, because that's not your time, not your agreement. And sometimes astrally, you don't remember you being extracted out of our hologram, because right now this reality is a hologram. You can be extracted out of the hologram and you can be with the ETs, for example, for 5 days. You don't even know it. And they bring you back from that hologram with them into this one 2 seconds before, for example, we have the webinar. And you don't have any idea that you were with them. The reason is because you're vibrating, because all the realities are running simultaneously. But what you're doing, you're shifting your consciousness, but you don't see them. You see what's happening right now. And the reason why you don't see me, because you may not be allowed to remember at this time, or because you didn't raise your consciousness to get and shift so you can see permanently. That is very important for you guys to understand.
Okay, let's move on to the next one. They're building up here. Jenny wants to know, does everyone have a galactic family?
Every single one of us have galactic family. Let's do okay, they told me to do exercise. Let's do one of the exercise. Now close your eyes.
I'm doing it.
Okay, and now think of an image of your galactic family. Have an image. In that image, see how they look like. Where is the spacecraft? Is this a spacecraft? What does it look like inside? What did they say to you? How do you look like? So now open your eyes, and I guarantee you that every single one of you had an image of your galactic family. Now, by law, if you had an image of your galactic family, that means that that reality and this galactic family already exist. Let's go into the bylaw. That's a quantum bylaw they taught me. You cannot think of something or put an image of something if you do not know the vibrational sequence of that reality. That means that you already exist in that reality, parallel reality, in order for you to even visualize it. If you don't know the vibration of it, it cannot come into your consciousness. So that means, ladies and gentlemen, that we all already exist in this reality. What you're doing right now is moment by moment crystallizing it physically. Because we need to crystallize it and have a certain vibrational sequence in order to crystallize it. I always say, if you are thirsty, one drop of water will not fill your thirst. It has to be the full cup. So in order for us to have this physical contact, we have to stay with it. You have to know it. You have to start connecting telepathically in order for you to manifest it in a physical form. How are you going to manifest it? Remember, that is fundamental. It's different for every single one of us. I may have a physical, you may see a spacecraft. Somebody else may go into lucid dreaming and have a contact. The third person did astral projection, literally. That fourth person had a dream, because that is the agreement. It's coming different. Don't expect that it's going to be the same for everybody. It's different for everybody depending on your agreement. And could be a collective also. Again, that will be by agreement. While some people will be absolutely oblivious of extraterrestrial knowledge, you may have absolutely contact with them. Why is that? Because they're vibrating in a completely different reality than yours. Okay? I hope that's clear enough. What is the next question, Rob? Crystal lighting or Melissa, does this apply to having children? My higher self and others in the different levels have to agree. Yes. In order for you to have a child, you already made an agreement. Even so-called incidental, you know, pregnancy is not incidental. It's always by agreement. Somebody open a microphone. I can hear myself double. Okay. Why do I hear myself double? Can you close all the microphones, please? Ron? I don't hear Ron, guys. Okay. Everything is done by agreement. Even so-called incidental pregnancy is not incidental. It's by agreement. I hear echo in my chat room.
Sorry, Marina. I had to restart my internet. My whole computer just froze. All right. Can you hear me okay now?
I can hear you. Yes.
Okay. Sorry about that.
It's all right.
Okay. So are you on?
Oh, hold on. I'm in the middle of, were they listening or not listening?
Yeah, I think everything was okay. It was just on my end. I put my computer and internet froze and I couldn't see or hear you.
Okay. The question was for children. I still hear echo wrong. You have to mute your microphone maybe. Okay, now I'm fine. There's nothing incidental. Before my children were born, I talked to their souls before they were born. They chose me. My guidance told me there were actually two souls that came in. And they told me, Marina, agree for this particular soul. The other soul is not soul to be, is not a nice soul for you. So I asked for the soul that I wanted, and I talked to my son before he was born. I knew who he is. I talked to my second son before he was born. I knew some of the stuff that is going to happen because you're connecting with them through another parallel reality telepathically that they're existing at the same time. You're being chosen, guys. You're being chosen for all that, okay? So yes, you choose your children, the children chose, it's all by agreement. Not only that the child is choosing you, but you also choosing the child. You may not remember, because remember, we existing simultaneously on a lot of parallel realities to infinity, and you don't see the other side that you're existing on. What you're seeing is very small information that you're getting is very, very limited. The goal is to open your information, to open your channels in order to do that. Okay? Because then you're going to start connecting and perceiving all the information. And let me just say, channeling, don't think I'm the only one that channel. I'm not special. I'm exactly like you, but I'm just the head of the class. You can channel yourself by learning how to do that, by opening the channels, start implementing all this stuff and see what happens. Follow what I did. If you follow what I did, you may have results because I'm taught hands-on. This is the reason why I was doing that. I always said I was not even allowed to work so I can do this work. And now look at like, thank you so much for all this, your distribution, because it helps me to stay home and do this. But at the same time, I'm not judging everybody. You know, I want everybody to help each other out. Susan has a question. Name a book of lucid dreaming. Okay, it's by Nick Barrett, Lucid Dreaming. You can also find him on YouTube. If you put Nick Barrett, Lucid Dreaming, I think it's Nick, and Barrett is B-E-R-R-E-T. Nick Barrett, Lucid Dreaming.
Hey, Marina, going back to the galactic family thing, there is quite often the question that comes up, how do I know what galactic family I belong to?
The truth is that you may stop receiving a lot of information from high consciousness, loved ones that are in a different reality. And if you try to do telepathically, you can try to ask the question. Start asking the question and let the first thought that comes in come to you. Usually the first thought is the family that you're belonging into. Okay? And don't forget that we also can belong to a lot of galactic families running simultaneously realities at the same time. But by agreement, I'm connecting mostly with the Pleiadians and the higher consciousness of this. But I'm sure at the same time, I belong to a lot of different realities, galactic families. But by agreement, the way to come and help and do all this stuff is accordingly to literally what's happening right now. That was the Pleiadian connection.
See, I feel mostly connected to the Pleiadians, and I never told anybody that before, but I don't know why I feel that. So I don't know to trust it or not.
Oh, they just said, they were laughing. They just said, if you are part of this webinar, don't be surprised that you're not a Pleiadian. Okay? This is Pleiadian connection. You also have connection to hybrids. And everything I do, you would not be in this timeline if you would not have a connection, because when you talk to me, you're actually talking to them like I'm the vessel to them, and that's the reality. Okay, so welcome everybody to Pleiadian Connection Hybrids. And hybrids, okay, too.
Well, that's good. So should
And they were laughing. They said, well, guess what? Welcome to Pleiadian.
Well, should we all have blonde hair and blue eyes then?
Oh, that's not necessary. In Pleiadian cluster, it's a lot of different species. It's not only that.
You see a lot on the internet, blonde hair, blue eyes for Pleiadians, though.
Not necessarily.
Yeah, it's probably. Not everything you read is true, right?
Yeah. Crystal has a question, Ron. Could you be so kind to read it, please?
Yeah, I'm actually following
our
original question list. So you don't see that one with the window you have up. I have my control window up.
Then I'll let you be, so, then you control it.
Yeah, I want to catch all the folks that asked us questions almost an hour ago. We have some we're so behind on. Okay, so how do we deprogram ourselves from the belief of time? It's so difficult.
Now, we're going to go here a little bit into metaphysics. You have to train yourself to do that. The way they, first of all, remember when I was talking and explaining that there's no time through the metaphysics, that if you put a mathematical equation of me moving my hand and then to the result of that equation, you put the result of the cluster in the whole universe and the whole galaxy, you're flickering through time space. When you know that, put in your consciousness that you have everything right now, because the previous time does not exist. You're co-creating everything in the now. What happened 2 seconds ago, it's not you right now, because what you did was 2 seconds ago. You end up shifting from one parallel reality and projecting a brand new image of a hologram of everything you see around. You end up mimicking from a memory bank. You end up reprojecting a new reality again from 2 seconds ago. But that's not 2 seconds. We're talking quantum structures here. We're talking simultaneously. Okay? So you end up recreating over and over and over again to infinity a reality. And it's literally like a snapshot. Doom, 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 doom. Almost like a picture frame. And that picture frame, imagine, is a hologram, is a life structure. You can make it 3D. You can make it flat. And, oh, let me plug in for flat earth. You can look at flat earth, if they say called flat earth, if you look at through a hologram point of view. But you can make it three-dimensional as a three-dimensional structure, because every single molecule is three-dimensional structure, people. Okay? So if anybody says it's a flat earth, guess what? It is a flat earth, and it's also three-dimensional. Okay? It both structures. Okay? So I just wanted to plug this in.
Okay, so that question, by the way, was from Christine. The next question is from Rose, and Rose talks about angel numbers. Are the 1111, etc., angel numbers, notifications of a connection notice from the galactic family?
Yes, the 11 dimensional. Oh, what do you mean 1111? You mean the frequency, the number 1111?
When you see the number 1111 on the clock, you see it on your receipt, you see it when you're buying gas, when you start seeing that number a lot, it's the master number.
I got it. Okay, let me explain about numbers. Numbers, 1111 is a specific sequence in a quantum structure. It's usually connected with ascension process that, and it's showing you that you are exactly where you need to be. But at the same time, a lot of people are receiving the numbers for, you turn around and you see, for example, 404 or 303 or some other number. When you see a consistency of repetition of specific number, it's all, you end up from your higher consciousness putting that sequence there. A frequency, it's actually frequency, because it's showing you something. When you see repetition of these numbers, stop right there and pay attention of what really is happening at that momentum in your reality. Whatever is happening at that momentum, see the patterns of it and start investigating what it's trying to tell you, because this number for everybody is different. You end up putting it there to show you something. I cannot tell you what it's showing you. You end up putting it there as like some kind of a wake-up call. But is that for maybe you seeing somebody positive? Could be anything. For example, me, I end up putting in my timeline. Every time I see a garbage truck somehow appears in front of my car, something is happening, but it's not. It's some kind of a challenge is happening. And that I've noticed that the color of the truck, if it's white, is not big of a deal. If it's green, something more complex. If it's red, it's connected with something else. And I've learned that through the years. When I see it, I know maybe I'm going to a restaurant. The restaurant is not open another hour. And in the meantime, I had the green truck or the white truck in front of me, garbage truck. I've learned that through my years. So watch your lucid dreams or your dreams, patterns of the dreams. Put a notebook of your dreams, because it's showing you patterns. You end up putting it there to help you through the process. Everybody has to study it for themselves by keeping notes on it. Okay?
Okay, sounds good. Let's see where the next question is here. Okay, Steve asks, have you heard something about the sun is supposed to be going dark from February 10th to February 25th this year?
Okay, let us go. They wanted me to talk about this earlier. That's what I mentioned about the sun. Okay, they want me to explain to you the whole structure. Okay, I'm going to pull out. All right. Now, was that Steve?
Yes.
Hello, Steve. Thanks for asking. Okay. First of all, remember when I was talking about simultaneously running parallel realities and that everything of any probability exists in a structure of the quantum field. Now, if you read a material like this, what you're doing is, there's no judgment here, we're just explaining structure. You are putting into your consciousness a vibrational sequence of probability of reality like this. Why is that? Because that noticed and that word, that message has a certain frequency. That means you implementing that and projecting that in your consciousness of holographic expression. And if you keep reading and reading and reading, and you start now to infusing that probability in your reality, don't be surprised if this becomes part of your reality, because you end up tuning into this vibrational sequence, reading it all the time. Now you end up implementing fear into it. Instead of just reading it and say, oh, okay, whatever is probability of reality, doesn't have to be yours, and start reading something positive. This is the trick, how you shift in another reality except the one that is something negative happening. Because what they taught me, that those two reality of something happening to the sun and completely beautiful, easy transition into ascension, they both reality are running simultaneously at the same time. The reality that you're going to see is the reality that you are shifting your thoughts and infusing more into. So if you do not want this to be your probability, say thank you for showing me something, but I prefer ascension process to beautiful earth, easy transition, and now start reading messages with a beautiful earth, beautiful transition, all this stuff. All realities are real. All the negative messages could be real. All the positive messages are real. Everything is real. The one that you're going to see is the one that you're infusing and tuning more into, because you're projecting this over and over in your structure and you're crystallizing it. So if somebody is projecting messages about, oh, it's going to be the end and we're going to have a full collapse, and you create that through fear, then you're going to see the reality through fear. In the meantime, you don't understand that that person that is having these messages is extracting from the quantum field, a channeling information from the quantum field that already exists. That doesn't mean he's wrong, but you don't have to be part of that negative structure. You can choose to be through a positive, easy transition of ascension. So tuning into messages into the people that broadcast in positive. That's how you learn, because these two realities also exist simultaneously. They're all true. Which one you're going to see is the one that you infuse and going into more. Does that make sense?
Yep.
What is
okay,
the next?
So the next question, is the Christine asks, is the heart the same thing as the soul?
Let me explain again through the structure. The heart and the soul is the same thing. Why is that? Because I'm going to explain that in a structural quantum way. It's not going to be separated from the structure. Why is that? Because consciousness itself, it's a projection of a hologram. The one particle, consciousness is one particle that is vibrating in a, such a high speed of vibration that is appearing next to itself, next to itself, next to itself, next to itself, to infinity. And when you lower, when the magnetic and gravitational field of this frequency of sound and light Remember, every thought, every verb, everything is frequency and sign. When they create each other like a trinity structure, creates magnetic and gravitational field of plasma. And when they're starting to interact with each other, this one particle that appears next to itself and next to itself and next to itself is actually can become a matter because it becomes more dense. So consciousness itself is literally sequences of light, sound. And when you start manipulating different vibrational sounds and resonances, becomes holographic expression of different realities. So in actuality, you right now are one consciousness. All of us is one particle, but it's flickering to time space so quickly that you are projecting from your own consciousness. Me, I'm a part of you, but you're projecting me in your hologram so you can have an experience for ascension because this is what you agree to do. So I am you. Okay? It's one particle. Consciousness is one particle. So to your question, your heart is also the one particle of consciousness. It's projected from there. So consciousness is you. God, you are. Does that make sense to everybody now?
The best I can make of it.
Thank you.
It's hard to understand this stuff. I'm sure everybody agrees.
That's why we need to learn the structure. You learn the structure, it's like a map. It's going to make more sense to you.
Okay. And then Jackie asks if they can heal us. So they, I probably who you're channeling right now, folks like that, the higher beings, can they heal us?
They always put frequencies in, yes. Beings can come and heal you. They can do everything. Now, let me put this straight here. If you have by agreement to learn some kind of a lesson the way I did through my son and I'm doing through my son with celiac, no matter what I did, I could not change anything. What they told me is accept. Because I was fighting and feeling sorry for myself. How come I'm doing all this stuff? How come I'm shifting? Nothing is happening. This child is not getting better. Until they told me to accept it. And when I stopped fighting and start accepting it as a lesson, and everything that came in was a lesson to me to pull out, and I said, I'm a hologram, and I went through that. We found out that was celiac. We found what to do, and everything came in the open, but I stopped fighting it. That is extremely challenging, and I'm sure all of us are going through something like this. So, yes, if I have a lesson to learn, they're not going to come and purely heal my child right away because through the process of healing, I'm learning everything. And now tell me, would I be able to help you and talk to you about celiac disease, detox, and everything else if I did not go through that? That was a part of my agreement in order for me to help humanity the way I do that, because consciousness and detox and all that is connected. It's not separated. It's not separated. Everything is coming from consciousness, from the nanoparticles. Also, consciousness is also nano. Consciousness also is artificial intelligence. If it's anything created from consciousness itself, even the computer is consciousness. Because right now, the computer is vibrating a certain vibratory rate of frequency and sound. If you raise the frequency, you can literally shift it to another dimension. That's how you do teleportation. We can talk about this in a different webinar. Okay? So if it's there, if it's in front of you guys, if your computer right now is in front of you, you projected it from your consciousness. Okay?
Okay. All right. Let's see if we can plow through some of these questions real quick because our webinar is coming close to an end here. But we'll keep going as long as we can. Lindsay asks, going back to the sun a little bit, Lindsay asks, what does sun gazing do to the body? Like, what are the effects? Are there any positive or negative effects of gazing at the sun at certain periods of the day or night?
Oh, okay. That's what they told me. Guys, sometimes my message is simultaneous. It's like a knowing. And it's a picture, and I know exactly what to say. Oh, my God. I'm sorry. My dog again. Today is the day of my big dog. Okay. let me put it this way. We can hear ourselves simultaneously, immediately. Again, if it's by agreement. Okay? Sun gazing, it's good, but it's another permission slip for you to heal yourself. In actuality, if you go into your DNA, if you imagine your structure, and if you start imagining this, you're going to start seeing in your third eye, in your image, different structures of your body, of your DNA. Ask questions, getting into it, and start seeing your structure of the DNA and find exactly what you need to look for. It's going to guide you. Your higher self, your consciousness is going to guide you where you need to go. Tuning into that structure and know that you're healing yourself. And know that you are healthy because you're creating everything in the now. If you think that sun gazing is the one that is going to help you through in order to crystallize this type of feeling, what they taught me is I can imagine it and feel the vibration that I'm already healed. If right now I tell you you're completely healed, you're completely healthy, and you're so, so happy, ecstasy of happiness, that's what you need to hold in your emotional vibration right now, because this is the frequency that you are projecting into the quantum field. And in turn, through probability, is giving you back exactly this type of sequence to manifest for you whatever you're looking for. So your goal is to withhold the vibrational sickness of the vibrational sequence of that emotion of happiness and joy. Recall, they told me, that emotion and hold it by imagining all this joy and happiness. And hold it to the point that you get a goosebumps and tears. Then drop it and let it be. Don't question when, how, and from where it's going to come to you, because then you're going to put another code in there and you're going to stop the manifestation process. Does that make sense?
Yep. Okay. Next question. Erica. So here's a good one. And I've had a few people offline ask about this, about Standing Rock. She wants to specifically know, there's a lot of questions about Standing Rock, but this one is, are we lowering our vibration if we protest peacefully or share evidence on social media of violence towards the water protectors? And what do higher dimensional beings think about Standing Rock and DAPL?
Okay, I got information before that. If you remember one of the webinars when you asked me who's going to be the president, I said is not going to be Hillary. I said that on one of the stuff. But this is the time that they allow me to say anything. I know something about what is happening a little bit later. I just want to tell you this thing. The way they taught me was for you to know, not to believe, that knowingness is 100% of manifestation, that no matter what you see is part of a process of the ascension timeline. So if you want to help the Standing Rock, you can send donation, you can show what is happening, you know, but do not go after the people and do not hate the people that is doing whatever you so-called think is not right to do. Because remember, all the realities are true for themselves of the point of view of the person. If the person that is doing these so-called negative things is just a definition, because that person that is doing it is believing 100% that what he's doing is the right thing to do. Okay? So let them learn their lesson. Now the question is that against and hurting somebody, that person that is doing something on purpose to hurt somebody, remember, everything you do, think, it's a plasma and gravitational vibrational sequence. This person, particularly that is doing something negative, is projecting that in their reality. And now because the frequency of the earth and everything is increasing, this person is going to learn through synchronicity, everything they did to you, they're accumulating negative energy. So they're going to have to go and learn their lessons in another timeline or something else will happen. Your goal is to help the people that need to be helped without going and being mean against the people. Peaceful way of doing everything. Why is that? Because the peacefulness is through the love structure. When you project love, constantly and understand that that consciousness that is doing something negative is learning lessons, but you move on and help the people that need help, then you're projecting only the positive frequency from the love, and a negative structure cannot withhold positive frequency of love. What you're going to do is, because you end up projecting only positive and accepting everything, you're going to create and shift ascension of a timeline that no matter what you see is going to have a positive outcome. So it doesn't matter what somebody else is doing. You be the beacon of giving and sharing and helping. It doesn't matter what somebody else is doing, because they're there, believe it or not, to wake up the rest of the humanity that what is happening is wrong. Humanity needs to be liberated. By you to see that, in order for you to see this reality, you have to be the liberation. You have to be the positive. And that's why there are a lot of people that bashing this group or that group. Oh, I can't believe you voted for this person or you voted for that person. Respect everybody's belief system, because that person that is doing this is projecting out of your consciousness. That person that you're talking against, it's you. So do not go against the structure, accept the structure, but you project the positive, whatever you wish to be and to create for your reality. So stop pointing fingers to each other who did what. Project positive and know that everything will happen. Everything needs to escalate. And what they told me, you need all the negative structure to crumble first in order the new structure to come in. You cannot build a new building in an old structure. So believe it or not, first of all, I'm going to say only that and I'm not going to say more. In order for you to have a free energy, listen carefully, because it's an underlining message that I'm not going to reveal more about it. In order for you to be free of energy, you need to be independent on oil and gas first. Think what I said here. We'll talk about it one day, about this when the time is right.
Yeah, I'm going to let my big question about
this
it
this country has to be independent on oil and gas first.
Well, my thing is that oil and gas is definitely not our future. It's our past.
No, it's not our future. But think why I'm saying
our
that.
Our past.
One day, if I'm allowed, I will talk about this, but this is not the time.
Okay, so let's move on to Melissa. Melissa says, does spinning or whirling, like the Sufis, I'm not sure who that is, help create a higher frequency in the body? If so, what direction, left or right? I heard a different channeler talk about this form, this from the Palladians, and I would just like to confirm that. So she says, does spinning or whirling like the Sufis? S-U-F-I?
Yeah, I'm getting info now. Let me just get the info. I'm getting images. Okay. Now, again, we're going into permission slips. For every single person, the integration for that will be depending on the person agreement. So, yes, it's possible. But then you have to know the proper sequence of spinning for that particular individual may not be the same for everybody. And the reason why they show me that is because everybody vibratory rate of consciousness and understanding is different. So if you implement for everybody the same thing, it may infuse it, but doesn't mean it's necessarily the proper one for that person. So that's why the best thing to do is when you connect with remember, I don't know if you read my harmonic reactor material. In the harmonic reactor, through the harmonic reactor, which was the teleportation device, you know, they had to measure every single person individual vibrational sequence in order to get through the portals. You cannot get into another portal when you do not have the sequence of it. You can't get in there. You're not allowed to be in there. You're simply going to be blocked from it or pop out of the reality. You can disintegrate. Depends what you're doing. So that goes into that. Is there more questions? Yeah.
Yes, plenty. let's see. Okay, Z asks, how can I find out more information about past lives?
Okay, let's us rephrase. They said that it's not past lives, it's lives that simultaneously running with you. Okay, sometimes you're not allowed to know certain information. Okay, so even if you want to tune in for a certain past life, you may not be allowed to get the information. And let me explain. The reason for that could be that, for example, imagine in a past life you were a killer, because we all did stuff through different realities. And now you are going through some kind of a very dramatic experience because you have to clear out that energy that you end up accumulating out of balance with the true source of law of creation. So now you're going to learn about that, that this is not good to do. Well, if you have memory of this particular parallel reality, you're not going to be able to complete your life mission here, lesson here, because it's going to be from within so painful that it's going to throw you completely off balance. So everything that is happening for a reason. So sometimes you not be allowed. If you're allowed to have a connection, we just did the exercise. I ask you to imagine your galactic family, your spacecraft. If it's there, you're already connected with it. What we're doing now is practicing to crystallize it. So eventually we all, in our own time by agreement, have, because one of you, just because watching this webinar tomorrow, may have a lucid dreaming or have a completely physical contact even before me. Because that's the agreement. You just needed some kind of a sequence, or maybe they did something because you're tuning into the frequencies when you're talking to me, you know, of these particular beings. And maybe you needed some kind of a twitch, and voila, you're in contact. Okay.
Okay, somebody so else? We'll move on. Yeah, we'll move on to the next one. How do we, Christelle says, how do we know what type of agreement we made just by what and how we are reconnecting now? Or she says, e.g., astral, lucid, physical, I feel and I travel. So my agreement is in connecting those ways only. Detox is key then.
You're going to have disconnections until you get guidance how you can, you may start doing the way I'm doing it. You can start practicing this so you don't have to go to sleep in order to have the contact the way, for example, I'm doing it. Okay, so you may start practicing to do that. Start thinking, start imagining the way we did the practice today. Next time we're going to do it again, something else, you know, something, because what you're doing is you're putting a vibrational phone call of a resonance and a frequency towards this consciousness. You end up extracting it from it. So that means you exist in that reality. So do that. Imagine your connection. Listen to, after you give the question, what is the answer? And what's going to happen more and more and more, you start tuning into these realities. All of a sudden, you're going to see something happening to your daily life that is going to prove that whatever you end up hearing is correct. That's how you're going to start learning. That's how you're going to start trusting the way I did. Because don't believe for a second that everything they told me in the beginning, I blindly start doing everything they told me. No. I start doing completely different stuff. And every single time I did something else, every single time I end up in a situation, and when I start doing whatever they ask me, everything smooth out and everything start working. That's how you know who you're dealing with. And do not put any thoughts. Let me explain that. Don't put any thoughts that whoever you're talking to, it's a negative consciousness. If you think this way, you're giving the probability for that sequence to happen to you. Stay on a higher frequency. If you hear something that doesn't resonate with you, you don't have to agree, but you project to that image and that thought positive and say, thank you, I love you very much, thank you for showing me, it's part of consciousness, but I believe something, and you start tuning in something else, but do not reject it and do not get into fear. Because then you're lowering the frequency. And yes, if negative consciousness exists, you're given an open door for anybody to come in with a negative. Why? Because you end up matching their frequency. So stay in a vibration of love and gratitude. Because negative structure cannot withhold that. Even if you see it, don't panic. Acknowledge, because it's part of structure, part of projection, part of consciousness. You cannot reject consciousness. But you can move on and do something else. Of course, okay. Whatever you're excited
for. Okay, so we'll move on to Catherine. Catherine is asking, is it true, because she's heard lately around that we are no longer bound by our agreements anymore and that we can change our contracts?
Yes, very good question. Thank you. That is not particularly true, because if you have an agreement to come to, for example, the way I did it, trust me, I had a physical interruption that they did something to stop me of doing what I did, because I have to complete what I agree upon. You see what I'm doing. Okay. You cannot get out of your agreement. The only way you're going to get out of your agreement, if, for example, the higher consciousness that is above the extraterrestrial structure, with your permission and the higher council agree to change something in a bylaw. That is all happening in another level by agreement. If, for example, they see that you absolutely don't do what you told, or you're not following, or you become very greedy, or you start doing everything lucrative and stuff like this instead of really helping, they are going to switch or pull out or something like this, and they will definitely have a plan B with somebody else that will come out. That's why they were saying that your fame and glory is not the criteria for them, because you may have an agreement to come and help and do all this stuff, but if all of a sudden you shift and start doing everything through a completely different behavior and stop being mean to people, or your ego went into place. If anybody listened to my stuff, if you remember what happened to me with my BMW, now I have different car. I start showing off a bit with the keys. And I had a car crash with another BMW. And the first thing that I heard was it matter what type of car you're driving? Because if I was okay and if I wasn't showing up, that would be okay. But even with everything I know, because it's so sneaky, it's so easy to get into the ego structure, because people start looking differently. You feel good in luxury. I should have known better. This is how easy it is to get out of track. Okay? So you always level yourself. Always make sure that you're doing it of the benefit of from your heart of giving, not of showing off and not of ego structure. It's good to have your persona of who you are and not allow somebody to take over your belief system. That is not ego. That is a persona of who you are as a consciousness. Ego is when you put towards that persona false pretenses that is keeping you off the track for the true self of consciousness, which is love and giving and sharing. Huge difference. Okay?
Okay. Next question is, okay, Dennis asks, while we're shifting and we shift into different realities, do we like lose the people that are in our current reality and the things we're experiencing in the current reality? That it's mostly about the people around.
Very, very, very good question. Thank you so much. Okay. So now I was talking that when there is no time and you're projecting and switching, and that particle is shifting and projecting from another parallel reality to another next to itself, next to itself, next to itself, to infinity. What you're doing is you're projecting out of your consciousness hologram, moment to moment to moment, and teleporting your consciousness with the new creation out of your image to a brand new earth. But what you're doing is, because of your belief system, you're reprojecting the same images. But these images, guess what? They're not the ones from the previous earth that you were projecting. They're completely brand new image. So you, yourself, and everybody else that you're projecting in a hologram are completely new holographic image. Now, your belief system may hold the vibration of some kind of a situation. And the reason for that is so you don't pop out of the reality. So if you're fighting with somebody right now, and you end up reprojecting the next section, the next moment again that you're continuing, right then and there, you can choose to say, thank you, let's not fight, I understand, how about we discuss this a little bit later. Right here, you end up switching the reality because you recognized it. Okay, and now from that momentum that you chose now to shift that emotion, because you were carrying echo vibration from the previous to show you where you at so you don't pop out, you can choose it, this new momentum that you projected, to switch into the positive. And now from that momentum, you start projecting more and more into the positive. Even if that person continue yelling at you, you keep giving positive and positive and positive until eventually the person may get tired and say, I don't want to talk to you anymore. And the whole fight end up stopping. What you did was, is keep projecting and shifting constantly, positive, 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 every quantum new structure, every time. And in turn, you crystallize completely new reality that the outcome of all that interaction end up being in a positive. So end up shifting and creating a brand new reality with a positive outcome, even when you started with something negative. Your goal is to recognize it and to shift it by implementation of a positive frequency and action towards it. So you basically recreated a brand new reality and reprinting the image of that person, but you and that person is completely new image. So my friends, that's why it's no reason for you to be upset at somebody 5 years ago. Can you believe what this person did to me? I'm going to continue to be upset at that person. What you're doing is you're extracting that reality image out of the quantum field that exists somewhere, but is not you right now. And you keep bringing it into your reality at this moment. And now you're running a completely brand new reality, again with problems with that person, because you never let go of that sequence. You never changed it. You need to replace it. Does that make sense?
Yep, sure does.
Okay,
so let's go on to Anita. Anita asks an interesting question. It's about the crafts, UFOs. Are they the physical construction of them in our third dimension? Are they government craft? And then she says, are all of our galactic families in light ships and only able to be seen in the clouds or as lights right now?
Again, if you believe that everything you see in the three dimensional is only from the government, then that's what you're going to create. But in actuality, the extraterrestrial can lower the frequency of their crust and still become still appear in your reality. That means they end up lowering the structures and doing something so they can be seen, okay? Through different dimensions. They go through portals, dimensional portals, okay? And the reason why you can see them, because they can raise the frequency, they can pop out of the reality. In the meantime, they see you, don't see them. So, but again, if you believe that everything that is from the government, then that's what you're going to see. I know that it's all of it. But, and also the spacecraft could be from a lot of different dimensional places, 9 dimension, 11 dimension, depending of different species, where they at, what location, where they need to be, and what is the agreements. It's literally a melting pot of extraterrestrial races spacecrafts, and do not take it from the negative. Remember, we always discuss that we're going to do this through a positive structure. My channeling and everything we do is going to be through a positive structure, because at the same time, everything else also exists, but we're going to project only positive. That doesn't mean we don't reject everything else, but we're going to project positive, because I want to infuse the positive structure with your own consciousness. We're putting seeds right now, so that reality can implement in your structure. Okay?
Okay, so a quick question about that. The are there, in fact, ships or UFOs that people are seeing, because we're seeing it all over the world? Are there ships and UFOs out there from both the governments and the galactic beings?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
all
it
I
is.
Need to know. Okay, we're going to finish up here with just a few quick questions, and we'll finish up our webinar over the next 5 or 10 minutes. So, Knighton says, are 11th dimensional beings, are they Palladians or other higher beings? Or maybe there's many.
Okay, we are structural sequences of different dimensional beings. That is a galactic organizations from a lot of high end conscious beings. The reason why we say that is because in order for you to even have implementation in that, you have to have a vibratory rate in our sequence. This is the reason why we thank you for having this interaction with us, because this way you will be able to see us. That is a very high resolution of sequences. Yes, you may perceive it. It's more work to be done, but you do have the connection.
Okay. All right. And then Z asks, what is the best way to meditate, and how do we know which crystals help us get aligned?
Oh, well, I'm hearing a name of Umborium. I don't know how to spell it. I never heard of it.
I haven't either.
It's a crystal of Umborium. That is the name I heard. I don't know what it is. Just put it out there and, okay. They told me just the name is going to give you the proper sequence. Umborium is the name of it. So think of that crystal. It's not known.
Hmm. Yeah, I'm trying to find a spelling for everybody on that.
I'm going to spell it the way I end up hearing it. Umborium. That's how I end up hearing it.
Okay.
The crystals are also with the different sequences for every single person. Different sequence will be for different people. What they just gave me now is for whatever we're doing. Umborium.
Okay. Well, Liz typed, there is one called Borean.
I heard Umborium. Maybe it's a slightly different structure. I'm not sure. I can't tell you.
We can all research that a little bit after the webinar. Okay, the next question. Rebecca says, if you are Palladian, couldn't you also be from a root race prior to Palladians, like Larian or Sirius? So could you be more than one race from different lives?
Yeah, you can be. Well, right now, all of us are simultaneously running in a different life. Some of us have simultaneously parallel realities of Earth lives. Right now, you can exist like maybe you're a doctor somewhere, but you don't see that reality because by agreement, your soul, your oversoul, could be experiencing right now 3 or 4 different people on Earth right now. But the only reason you see, for example, yourself right now is because by agreement you decided to stick with that reality. Okay? But that could be also through Pleiadian, through Andromedas, through a lot of structure. And they don't forget that all these clusters, they say they're interconnected. They're working with each other. It's all for the name of humanity. And stop thinking about agenda. it's enough with the agenda. Who's having what agenda? We don't forget that we all are them. So the agenda is, yes, to connect with each other, to create races, to become intergalactic race, to help each other through all the structures. You know, that what is the agenda. How is going to be achieved? I wouldn't worry about that, because it's a lot of ways. Yes, it was a manipulation in the DNA structure. Why? Because you needed to create an inter-race. So it's easy transition to create the sixth race. That's why you had the hybrids that they were doing in so-called abductions, was basically by agreements. You gave an agreement so you can have you can give embryos and everything else so they can create a race like that. So you can have intergalactic connection. That's how it works. So don't take all this stuff into negative. You may find it as a negative because your consciousness doesn't understand it. But once you start tuning into the positive structure, you're going to see the positive outcomes for that. So don't panic in anything of that. Anything right now, let me just put it this way. Remember what they were saying. They were saying that no matter what some person, a negative side or whatever we try to do to humanity, it will be stopped in every corner. So even if you see that something is completely escalated and, oh my God, it started again, these people are completely what they're doing, it's a part of the ascension process. Some of this stuff has to come in the open in order the rest of humanity to wake up, because a lot of people are still asleep and the only thing they believe in is what is seen in the main media. Nobody's doing the research. Do your research. Don't believe me what I say. Go ahead and do all the research. Alternative media, now that some of them are not posting on purpose stuff to steer you off, but there are sites and there are people that already have the name of it. So you can see, you can find for yourself, all the information is there. And then is another thing. If you start vibrating, looking for the answers, because you end up tuning into the structures, the answer from consciousness itself is going to be given to you if you implementing that from the positive. From the fact you want to help humanity. Because the first time when I started listening to everything was for me to listen to everything about what the negative side was doing. It literally took a year. And I was crying. I was so upset because I realized how manipulated we were. But I had to learn all this stuff. And once I learned that, they said, okay, how do you change that? Here is the knowledge for the structure. Here's the structure for the quantum field. That's how you get out of it. You don't go fight the negative, because more you infuse, more you do that, more you infuse the negative structure. Whatever you tune in more, that's what you're creating more. So instead of projecting and complaining about the person that is doing negative stuff all the time, start talking about the people that are doing positive stuff all the time. It doesn't matter what the other person is doing, it's creating its own reality. You help the people that need help, and you be the beacon of help, joy, and love. That's how you do it. That's a quantum structure. Use it.
Okay. So what I'd like to do, Marina, is wrap it up there with like just one last question of the day. Anne asked a good question, and you may have just given us, you know, the message, but is there any other message for us all today that the 11th dimensional beings or anyone that's coming through your channeling now that they would like us to hear before we end this webinar?
Yeah, there's a message. Do we have Christine or Christina?
Yes, she's here.
Okay.
Are you still there, Christina? Can you type to acknowledge you're still on the... But she was here earlier.
Okay, her mother is not doing very well. To check her mother in particular health-wise. Okay?
Yep, there she is.
Mm-hmm. What is she saying?
She's just acknowledging that she's still here.
Okay. Something with her mother is going on.
As far as I can tell, there's only one Christine on the chat, but there, you know, there could be two.
Okay, I'm just giving the message, so they have to check that.
So it's for one of the Christinas out there, or Christines out there.
Mm-hmm. Her name is Christine, yeah.
Christine. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, everyone. I'd just like to say thank you to all of our previous supporters. We have a lot more today, I know, thanks to this great new software. I want to say thank you to all the previous supporters
for everything.
Who've donated. Yeah, you donated and helped us get this great new software. And We've had 83 people here today. We've had a 50% attendance rate, which is double what it's supposed to be. So that shows that we're doing some good things. Thanks to Marina. She's given us some information from her heart and soul that we're supposed to have. And those of you that are here are supposed to be here. So we hope that you'll join us every 2 weeks on Saturday. If that changes, I'll let you know. Maybe we'll...
Okay. I'm sorry, Ron, I interrupted you. Okay, next time we're going to continue with the messages again. We're going to go to day two, day three, and every time I play the message, I'm going to go, and that's how we're going to learn through the process. We're going to play the messages, we're going to discuss it, and then you're going to have 1 hour of questions, because I know the questions we get in a lot more information. Sometimes I don't know what they're going to say. Okay, so we're going to be 1 hour next time of the messages, and I'm going to discuss on top of that, and with your questions today, we're going to have another hour of questions. So then yeah, everybody will understand better stuff.
Yeah, just so you guys know, Marina and I have been doing this almost a year now on Skype for Business, which was not a very good, it was okay, but it wasn't good for us. And we usually do this for about an hour and 20 minutes, an hour and 30 minutes every other Saturday. So the next one is going to be February 18th. And Marina and I do, if we feel right, we just know it. And Marina and I just let it carry on for 2 hours. So it just depends how things are going and how much time we have. And we try to do these for free. So your donations really help Marina and I. I've put both Marina and my links up there at different times throughout this webinar to help us just to donate. We don't like asking for money. We're not about the money. We're not here for that. It's just that to keep these free, it really helps with your support. So thank you guys very much for that.
Okay, I just want to say, Tim. Tim is asking, how do I stop that constant chatting in my head? They're talking about you listen to Bach. Listen to the Bach and the Bach music. You need a specific frequency. Okay? And Rebecca is asking, if you're Pleiadian, could you also be from root race, Pleiadians, like Lear? Yes. You got to understand that our DNA has a lot of codes of this stuff. We are the melting pot of all these races. That's why planet Earth is so important. But depending on your agreement, which you activate and what connection you activate is going to be depending on the agreement. So, yes, you are part of all. We're part of all because simultaneously is running at the same time. Okay.
Sounds
Thank
good.
Thank you so very much, guys, for everything you do. Thanks for your donations. And I love you very much with all my heart. And I'll continue to do what I'm asked to do. And hopefully I'll see you every weekend. We can grow like a large community and help each other out. I strongly suggest interact with each other, exchange your numbers, sites, talk to each other, help each other in need, because that's how you crystallize the ascension process, by you being the beacon of light of love, giving and sharing. That's how we do the abundance.
Yeah, speaking of which, you guys, we're going to try to, myself especially, and I'm sure with the help of Marina, one of my goals, one of my things, my intuition I've received is we are going to build a group, a strong group of, we're going to start with 5,000 people, 5,000 of us who we can just build a group. I'll talk more about that later, but it's going to be great, positive things. So I'm going to send everyone at the end of this webinar, you will get automatically redirected. It's either this window or another window to our Facebook event page. And that's going to allow you guys to click on going to the event. It'll let you know you can click on going or interested. If you click on going, or maybe even anything there besides disconnecting from it, it's going to let you stay updated. Several times every week I post on there, sometimes daily I post things on there to keep you guys updated So just check out our Facebook event website, and it'll keep you updated to links and the webinar dates, if there's been a change of our webinar, things like that. So that's the main place to go for daily information, or bi-daily or weekly information on our webinars. As far as our webinar links besides there, if you register for this webinar, you're going to get emails 4 days before our next webinar, and then you'll get them again like 24 hours, 2 hours, and 15 minutes, okay? And if you think it's too many emails, you can tell me, or you know, write me on Facebook, or just unsubscribe, but then you're not going to get reminder notifications, but you can put it on your calendar. So that's about it, you guys. Next time, if you guys want to share your camera and your sound, all you have to do is click the button somewhere around the top right or top left of the chat, and you can request that, and it'll send me the notification, and I'll hit accept. But then when you guys do get on with us, we'll be able to see you with Marina and I, like everyone else sees us. They'll be able to see you and hear you. When you get on, you have to actually click the gray webcam button, and it'll turn blue, and then that means you're on the air. And then you have to click the gray microphone button, and it'll turn blue, and that means you're on the air. Okay, I saw 4 of you that tried to get on today, and I wasn't able to talk to you to let you know this, but I think that's what happened. I actually accepted you, but your video never showed up and your sound never showed up. And I think maybe you just didn't know to click the gray buttons to turn on your camera and sound. So anything else, Marina? That's it for me.
No, I just want to thank you. If you want to contact Ron or me, you can always go through my website or Ron's website. You know, guys, how to contact everybody. I want to thank you so very much for participating. And let's do good, you know, every day. Thank you so much. I love you all.
Thanks, you guys. We hope to see you again in 2 weeks on Saturday, but also in about less than 2 hours, you're going to receive an email link to this live free webinar replay. So you'll be able to see our webinar free, recorded, the replay at the link in the email, and you could share that with all your friends all over social media. That would really help our cause. And it's going to show you the webinar exactly the way it happened. You'll be able to see the chat and everything.
And also, please follow Matt McElroy of Galactic Federation of Light. It's an amazing person. He has a lot of postings there. Whatever you like to watch or resonates with you, you know, it's a lot of messages there. So tune in his site and maybe subscribe for his channel, because a lot of information is coming. We also going to post a lot of the webinars through his channel. I talked to him. He agrees. He was such a beautiful human being to do this for us, so we can reach a lot of people to, you know, create this community. Thank you so very much, and I'll see you next time.
Okay, you guys, we'll see you next time. I'm going to type in here Matt's name. There you go. You can find him on YouTube and subscribe to his channel, and also subscribe to Marina Jacoby's YouTube channel, and then Live the Enlightened Lifestyle YouTube channel. And that will keep you in contact with us and what's going on. It'll keep you abreast of fully updated of all of our events and information. Okay, you guys, we'll see you later. I'm going to redirect everybody to our Facebook event page now, so you'll know more about our events and webinars. Thanks, Marina. I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you. Bye-bye.